It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show. It's the Andy Snowden Radio Show.
Well, what is there to go and see? What can I do tonight, Andy? I hear you chunder. Well, let me tell you about this, right? Over the past 3 or 4 years, Theatr Clwyd have been world leaders in the art of immersive storytelling, placing the audience right in the middle of the action. And on the 21st of October, they'll be taking to the streets of Mold to recreate the Mold Riots of 1869. This 150-year commemoration tells the story of the miners who stood trial for attacking the manager over wage cuts, leading to the riots and subsequent deaths of 4 miners. The cast and crew includes over 150 community players, as well as some helpful professional actors and creatives. Written by Bethan Marlowe and directed by Katie Posner and Gethin Evans, this production is one heck of an undertaking. And I popped up to rehearsals last Saturday and caught a word with community players Bill Woods, Sam Wise and Karen Campbell, the director of creative engagements Gwenan Meyer-Jones, and Gethin Alderman, who is one of the 4 professional actors joining this mammoth production. So here we go then, on the stage and screen show, Calon FM, the cast and the creatives of the Mold Riots. This is amazing.
We've got about 3 weeks to go, and we have the guest actors that have joined our community cast of 100. And yeah, it's a Saturday and we're in rehearsals on a beautiful day. Yeah. I hope it's going to be sunny in October.
Yeah. Is there anything set in place? I mean, it's obviously outside. The one question everybody asks, what happens if it rains? What does happen?
Absolutely. I think we'll have to just see.
Get wet.
And there's something really beautiful about coming across those barriers when they happen and kind of having everyone all on, you know, on side to go, right, what do we do? And yes, bring your umbrellas. That's all I'm saying, really.
That's a good tip. Should put it on a ticket.
Yeah, we should. Yeah, bring it's raining.
Yeah. But, I mean, logistically, on that point, what actually happens in the streets of Mold? Are you going to close Mold down? How does it work?
So, technically, there's a couple of road closures, but they're not going to be all the time. They're going to be staggered throughout the night when the production is on. And yeah, we're taking over the streets. We are performing in the middle of Mold, an immersive piece of theatre that tells a really, really important story about Mold's history, you know, 150 years ago.
Yeah.
And it's been told by the community, for the community, and with the community.
Yeah.
And this is the first time we've ever done this before here at Theatr Clwyd. And I think it's a really, really special time for us to, you know, come off the hill and immerse ourselves within the community and let the community can take over.
I mean, yeah. I mean, and it's important, is it, that you've used community cast? Are they backstage people as well?
Or? Yeah, so we've got around, I'd say, about 150 people engaging in this project. Around 100 in the cast that are performing. And I think there's something really important about the people telling their story, you know?
Yeah.
And then we also have a stage management group, a group of knitters that have been knitting rocks for the last 6 months. We've got a costume making group. We've got local choirs coming to join on different evenings. What else do we have? A young directors group. You know, so we've got a photography group, an arts group that's going to create an installation here up in Theatr Clwyd as well. So there has been opportunities to engage with us in whatever your you know passion is, even if it's not just performance.
Yeah.
But the you know we're a producing house. We make theatre. So if that's from painting sets to you know the directing of it, from the performing side to the lights to the technical elements, that all happens within our building.
Yeah.
So we should be giving those opportunities to our community to to get involved in whatever they want to get involved in, really.
Theatr Clwyd, at the moment, so many brilliant things that they're putting on, especially with community players. I mean, but this is something else, isn't it? This is
a bit... Just the size of it. I mean, we've done lots before, but the sheer size of this, each rehearsal you come to is sort of like some kind of psychological experiment because there's people doing different things all over. I've done a lot, but I've never been involved in anything as complex as this. And also the fact that we're in two languages, and that, you know, we've got English and Welsh within the cast.
Yeah, you did almost the same, didn't you?
As well as, I mean, the text is all about the conflict between English and Welsh, and hopefully it's not like that in rehearsals.
But it's actually getting history out there to people who are local, who don't know about these things. You know, I actually didn't know much about it. So here, we're learning as we're performing.
Yeah.
And hopefully that message will go across to the audience. So I actually hope a lot of schools come to this.
It's a commemoration rather than a celebration, I think. And the fact that we're actually performing outside is it's a tremendous feeling. You know, you're out there and don't know what the weather's going to be like.
And some of it, you know, is just around the corner from where the actual riot happened.
Exactly.
Yeah. Absolutely.
So that memory of those people brought back in. One of the people who was killed is buried at St. Mary's Church, just the church up on the hill.
Yeah,
and that's where we go to.
Right.
Yeah. So we're very much in the area where the actual riot happened. So that's incredible.
And I'm sure an awful lot of local people have never heard anything about this.
No.
It's not taught in the schools. You know, we don't know anything about this. And it is an important part of trade union history, in fact, that they were all sentenced. But it was unfair and it was unjustified. And I mean, it is a huge calling card, I think, about Welsh history.
It is, because all over Wales there's always been miners' strikes, miners' riots. There's the slate mine, the quarrymen riots. So this one, and you know, the families who live now, their ancestors, we're in those times. I hope we do it justice.
It's probably quite a good time to actually do it as well. The political situation we find ourselves in.
Divided countries.
Oh my God.
People on different sides.
I've forgotten people without a voice, you know.
Exactly.
It's all there.
Yeah. And it's amazing as well, even though it's a play, and I just watched that excerpt of your rehearsal, how you can, it angers you, the attitudes towards, from the English towards the Welsh. So I suppose to a certain extent it still happens today.
But I think for a lot of people it will be uncomfortable, you know, realising this really did go on, you know, because it's been talked about before, but then seeing this and then understanding how really badly the Welsh were treated, and I think it will be uncomfortable, you know, to watch in parts.
You know, there's 200 audience, 100 community cast.
Yeah.
It's big.
Yeah.
And then we have all those people going up the hill towards the church, you know, it will take over the town.
It will.
And the court case, the actual court case, when the miners are going to be sent to prison or whatever punishment they have, that is actually going to be filmed in the council chambers. It would have been wonderful if we could have got audience in there, but it's really quite tiny, so we can't. So that is going to be filmed beforehand, but then screened
three
to the audience who are standing outside in the Daniel Owen Square.
And then that's where the riot starts.
Mm. Okay.
And they're kept outside much like most of the miners, because there were 200, 300 miners in this riot. They weren't just the miners from that colliery.
Yeah.
Other collieries had got together because they wanted to show their support, so it's sort of the audience getting kept outside, much like them. It's like, what's going on? And then it just kicks off.
Yeah,
it's being hailed as a record breaker, yeah. And one of the top 12 things for to go and see this autumn. That must be amazing.
I think the fact that, you know, we've got really good directors and really good guest actors with us, that will make it, as well as the enthusiasm of all the people, you know, the community players.
Yep.
I think that's what will make it epic.
The children in it—they are pivotal to all of this.
They're amazing,
and they are absolutely brilliant. They pick up things and they do it straight away. They are fabulous.
But I think another key factor, which will be the killer on the nights, is the music and the singing.
Yeah.
And the thought at the end at the church.
Oh yeah.
There's all the cast plus choirs just singing a Welsh hymn. I mean, in rehearsal when we did it, I started to go. I think it's going to be incredible. It's a working man I am, and I've been down underground, and I swear.
It's a very political play. It talks about a lot of topics to do with language, to do about working under I guess situations that potentially was dangerous at those times, you know, human rights and working rights. Mm-hmm. And I think it's a play that is really relevant to today, actually, and to where we are at the moment politically as well.
Yeah.
I think there's absolute parallels in what we're saying. It's very powerful, and you know, four people died, you know, it's a tragic story really, but there's something really, really incredible about bringing this story home.
So there you go, one of Wales's forgotten dark days is brought to life in this large-scale promenade show through the streets of Mold with a cast of over 100. It's called Mold Riots, and it's an immersive play. It runs from the 21st of October until the 26th of October. Want to get yourself a couple of tickets? Box office number 01352 344101. That's 01352 344101. There you go. Mold Riots taking place on the streets of Mold. Go on, support your local theatres, girls and boys. They will not be there forever if you don't.